and let us sit in the presence of the Almighty God, that we may hear the word of God today. We want to thank God because He has given us victory. The whole week we have been up and down, working and doing the will of the Father. And I want to thank God because I know God is faithful. Amen. To those who call upon the Lord, He was reminding me today, this week, that those who call upon the name of the Lord, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Amen. And I thank God because I know whoever shall call upon that name, whether their things are good, whether things are bad. He didn't tell us that call upon Him when things are good. He said, whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that is the testimony and the view that we have today, that the Lord has given us victory over the powers of darkness, over the principalities, over every schemes and plans of the evil one. We are more than conquerors because the Lord has given us victory today. Amen. May the Lord bless you so much. Thank you for joining us. It is always an honor to host you today in this Sunday service. And the Lord has prepared a word, powerful word, for us today, that we may learn and understand how to walk with Him. Because one thing that I know, if you don't know how to walk with God, you cannot partake of what He has prepared for you. But if you know what He wants and you do it, then you are able to be entrusted by the things of God. Amen. Therefore, I thank God. We've been discussing about the benefits of what? Of reading the Bible. Hallelujah. The benefit of having a Bible study. Why should we study the Bible? Yeah? Somebody was asking me, why is this important? And I shared on Friday, I was telling us that if you don't read the word, you don't eat. Word is the spiritual food for a spiritual man. And anyone who wants to walk with God must understand what He wants. You cannot understand God without reading the word. Hallelujah. And I say that the word of God is the breath of God. When God breathes in and out, He breathes His word. So, and when we listen, when we read the word, we are eating the bread. And I remember when I was continuing to study this word, that when God made man, He breathed into him, and man became man. Amen. He was not a man until God breathed into his nostrils. Hallelujah. So we are alive by the word, by the breath of God. And because the word of God is the breath, and if you don't breathe, you die. It means a spiritual man must be fed on a daily basis. Hallelujah. And I said, number one, if you read the word of God, benefit number one is that you grow spiritually. Anyone who eats physically grows. Amen. And you know, we eat balanced diet. You can't eat carbohydrates alone and expect to grow well. Amen. You eat balanced diet food. And I said, your spiritual diet is very important to your spiritual growth. And we say that if anyone who eats, anyone who feeds the breath of God, that person grows spiritually. And we say that Paul told us, the last thing I said is that Hebrews chapter 5 verse 12 to 14, that now we ought to be teachers, but because we have refused to eat the food, the spiritual food, we have remained babies. And Paul was telling us, now we ought to be teachers. And I say, some of us today are supposed to be prophets, we're supposed to be teachers of the word, we're supposed to be pastors, but because we are malnourished spiritually, we are still babies. And I said, number two, when you read the word of God, it keeps you from sin. Hallelujah. And we saw David saying that he has hidden the word of God in his heart, that he may not sin against the Lord. Hallelujah. So anyone who eats the word, anyone who invests in the word of God, this person is kept away from sin. I want to continue from there, and I was just doing a recap. Number three, when you read the word of God, when you invest your time in reading the word of God, the word brings healing and health. Hallelujah. People that read the word, what you are going to say, believe, people who understand the Bible, the people who take their time to read and understand the scriptures, they are healed and they are healthy. Hallelujah. So if you see someone who is malnourished, someone who is not a spiritually fat, this person is sick. Most sicknesses in the church are brought because of lack of what? Reading the word of God. up. Let us go to the book of Exodus. Exodus 15, verse 26. We will start from there. Hallelujah. Exodus 15. The Bible says, 26, if you will listen carefully to the voice of the Lord your God and do what is right in his sight, obey his commandments and law, then I will not make you suffer the diseases I sent on the Egyptians, for I am the Lord who heals you. Hey, hallelujah. If you listen, if you obey, and listening is carefully, don't just listen. If you listen carefully, hey, and you obey the voice of the Father, then the diseases of the Egyptians will not be your portion. The Lord will prevent you. The Lord will separate you. The Lord will protect you from the diseases the moment you invest your time in reading the Word. People that read the Word of God are people that God protects, are people that are in the will of God. Hallelujah. God told them that, yet I will not make you suffer the diseases I sent in Egypt. If you know the commandments and obey the commandments and listen to the voice of God, then the disease of the Egyptians. You know, Egyptians, I can compare them to the people of the world. Eh? The disease the people of the world are facing. Praise the name of the living God. The problems, the torture, the lack of faith that they are suffering from. If we can only read the word of God, if we can only spend our time in the Bible, then the diseases of the Gentiles will not be our diseases. The people who are in the world, we shall be healthy. We shall be telling them, come to Christ that you may receive help. Come to Christ that the Lord can heal you from your diseases. Why? Because we are full of the word of God. The word of God is food. Therefore, when you eat the food of God, you become healthy. And the diseases of the heathens, of the Egyptians, of the people, imagine, you are a believer. And like now, people are hiding from corona. And you are also hiding. You're supposed to come out and tell people, God can heal coronavirus. God can heal every disease. To anyone who understands the word, he says, I will heal you. Oh, not that I will send anyone. The Lord himself will come and heal them that invest their time of pain and listening carefully to the will of God. and he saved them from their distress. He spoke and they were healed, snatched from the door of death. Let them praise the Lord for his great love and for all his wonderful deeds to them. Hallelujah. When God speaks to us, when God's word, when the breath of God leaves his mouth, when it comes to a human being, it becomes healing. God can never speak a holy word that can go out in vain. He says that nothing that he has released, the word that he has released, cannot go back to him void. When the Lord says, I will heal you, when the Lord says, I will lift you, the Bible tells me he spoke. God just spoke, and the people were healed.
Back. That promise, challenge,
Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Number four, when you read the Bible, the word brings freedom. The Bible gives you freedom. You know, one day when I got it, it took long for me to understand the scripture. And one day when I was reading them, somebody came and gave me a small Bible, the Gideon's, the New Testament. And I sat down with that book one day. And when I was reading, because I felt as if I am not yet born again, I came across a scripture that says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that believe in the Lord. When I read that book, I read it 10 times because it enlightens me. It made me know that I am no longer under condemnation. But if I didn't have that book, if I didn't read that book, I would still be living a life of guilt. Hallelujah. Because some of us, God saved us from a very bad place. We were doing things that are bad. So when you come to Christ, the enemy will tend to take you back psychologically. He will tend to take you back and remind you of how you used to behave. But when I came across that one, I said, Kume, I am free. And they say, will the Son has set free? It's free indeed. I rose up and I said, I am born again indeed. Let me tell you, I was free from the chains of the devil.
He will always crush you down. He will always confuse you by the seeds that is
God's way of life. He will preach to you. He will tell you all. You are this, you are a failure. Huh? You can never be this. Even in your family, no one has ever risen to that level. Hey, tell him yes, but I will be the first one. Hey, I will be the first one to rise to that level. Even though no one rose to the level, but God blessed me. When Gideon was hiding, he didn't know that he was a warrior. Until the Lord told Gideon, a warrior, mighty man of valor. And then Gideon told God, who is that? Who is the mighty man? How can I be mighty when I'm hiding? Hey, let me tell you. People are built in times of crisis. A time like this, God is building warriors. A time like this, God is building people, an army that will come and fight for himself. Hallelujah. So, if you know the commandments of God, if you know the ways of the Lord, you understand your position. And nobody can push you out of your position because you know you are there legally. The blood of Jesus is what gives you the legality of being a son of God. So don't listen to any voice. Hallelujah. I want to tell you, don't listen to every voice now. The devil is preaching like no one, nobody's business. But listen to the commands of the Lord, because it will give you the understanding. Hey! Hallelujah. The Bible says that your word is a lamp for my feet and a light to my path. You understand you are standing, then the light of God will come.
Alive today.
The word who came to be because of the word. darkness. Let me tell you, for you to break force of darkness, you must be able to release the word. When Christ said, when God said, let there be, he released the word, and the word was affirmed by the power of the Holy Ghost. Psalms 119, verse 130. Hallelujah. The Bible says, as your words are taught, they give light. Even the simple can understand them. When the word of God is taught, like the way we are listening today and watching from wherever you are, when the word of God is taught, it gives light. Oh, Jesus said that the word became flesh or light. Hallelujah. This word became from the flesh, and this word was the light of the world. Hallelujah. So when the word comes out, when you are through the word of God, it brings light. You know, I say, when you are in darkness, when you're in a room that has no power, you don't even know, even if it's your own house, where the spoon is. Hello? You can sleep hungry because you don't know where you kept your plate. But when the light is put on, you are able to see everything clearly. The word of God reveals to us the hidden things in our lives. Anyone who reads the word has a revelation of everything that is happening upon the life, because God speaks. So that's why he said, you shall get the prophecy by the word. Hallelujah. Prophecy, when as the word, is not prophecy. We can only get your prophetic word through the word of God, because the word affirms everything that is godly. If it is released the word, it is not the word of God. Am I speaking to someone today? So when the word of God is taught, if they give light, even the simple can understand. I said on Friday, the word of God is too simple. It is me and you who complicate the word. Hallelujah. The word has been made even for a child to, when they read the word, they understand. But because we want to put our theological sense in the word, we make it so complicated. But the simple are supposed to understand the word, because it is taught and it becomes simple to us. Hey, am I talking to someone today? Hallelujah. Therefore, let us know that the word of God brings freedom. We are made free by the word. Jesus said, it is finished. That was our freedom. Everything that Christ came to do, he finished it by the one word on the cross. It is finished. Hallelujah. Therefore, we walk knowing that we are free from the chains of Satan. We are made free by the power of God's word. Oh, hallelujah. Number five. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Number five. The word of God brings prosperity. I know we like that part. When you speak about prosperity, everybody becomes a light in the church. When you can talk about prayer and fasting, people start sleeping. Huh? When you talk about giving, you start going to the toilet. Hello? Praise the name of the living God. But the word of God brings prosperity. The people who take time to read the word, they prosper. Automatically prosper. Amen. I will take you the book of Joshua chapter 1. Verse 8. From verse 6. Joshua chapter 1, verse 6. The Bible says, be strong and courageous, for you will lead my people to possess all the land I swore to give to their ancestors. Be strong and very courageous. Obey all the law Moses gave you. Do not turn away from them. You'll be successful in everything. Study this book of the law continually. Meditate on it day and night, so that you may be sure to obey all that is written in it. Only then will you succeed. Hallelujah. Let me read that in New King James. New King James. This book of the law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate in it day and night, that you may observe to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your ways prosperous, and then you will have good success. Hallelujah. Joshua walked with Moses. He was the right hand man of Moses, right? God spoke to Moses in a mighty way. But when it came to Joshua, God never spoke to Joshua. God just told Joshua, obey what is in the law of the book that Moses gave you. Because God knew if Joshua can just understand the law, then prosperity is upon him. Then victory belongs to him. Friends, for us to prosper in our lives, my friend, you cannot prosper if you don't observe. God told Joshua, read this word day and night. Joshua was a king. Huh? Joshua was a king. A king's temple is full of issues. It's like telling your president to read the Bible day and night. He has so many things at hand. But God told Joshua, for you to have success, then you must invest your time reading the Bible. Because I will give you the land, but I won't give you the land if you don't follow the commandments that Moses gave to us. So for you to succeed, the law must be part of you. The law must be in your heart, not just written there. The law must be in your heart. That's why I was told, read this word day and night. My friend, if God told Joshua, who is a king, to read the word day and night, what about me and you, who are not kings? When we stand in that seat, I don't know what will happen to us. If you don't have time to read the word of God, you will be answerable before the Lord Almighty when he comes. Hallelujah! Because Joshua's success was spent to reading the Bible day and night, reading the word of God. So for you to be successful, don't read about how 100 ways to become successful. Those people are writing their own ideas. I have a book I was given, How to Be Rich.
Hallelujah.
There are people who have prospered.
but they don't have good success. The deal is good success. You know, there is success, but there is good success. For you to enjoy good success, and you know what I'm talking about good success? I talk about when I die. When I die, my world will live beyond my name. That is good success. Hallelujah. God said to Abraham, I will bless you up to 1,000 generations. That is the good success I'm talking about. Not the success that you alone, you are enjoying when you die with your wealth. No. Good success will go up to 10 generations. That is, and even when you die, they will say, this is the son or grandson of this person who died so many years ago, but their wealth is still running. That is what I call good success. Hallelujah. Good success is living a healthy life. You will not have money, but you have wealth. That is the best investment that God has given you. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. Hey, when you meditate on the word of, on the teachings of the word of the Bible, when you meditate on the teachings of the word, or when you take time with the word of God, then the fruits of that word become successful. So whatever you touch becomes successful. Whenever you speak, even when you start to preach, whatever you share becomes something that matters. Hello, I watched someone preaching, and I was asking myself, what is this person talking about? I didn't even understand myself, and I'm a pastor. And I was wondering, do the members of that church understand what he's saying? Because the foundation matters. Hallelujah. People can be, I was watching a movie, it is called, what is this called? Holy Elders. Please, when you have time, you can watch that movie. It's a good movie. If you have watched it, they are called Holy Elders. These people, they began their business well. But a time came when they were cheated by the devil. They are still holy, but bowing to another God. And there's one man who was so fiery, a man of God, full of power. But because he was going through a season of dry season, one of the friends came and told him, come, I introduce you to the holy elders. And the guy went there, power of the devil, but his aim was pathetic. So when you start well, God will give you the grace to finish well. But when you start in a bad foot, you will finish in a bad foot. Am I talking to someone today? Praise the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Friends, the word of God carries the power to take you into the next level of life. You cannot move to the next level by any other means. It is the word of God that will carry you to the next level. It will give you the next key. One day I was talking to my mentor, the man who mentors me in ministry, and he told me that God told him that in life we have so many keys that open so many doors. So where you are now, that door is opened because of the key that you use. For the next level, you need a different key, and that key is in the word of God. Hallelujah. So if you want to move next level, invest your time in the word. Read the Bible. Understand it. Don't just read to finish. Read the Bible to understand. Take a book and a paper. Sit down and read the word. Write down what you are reading about. Hallelujah. Because that is what will carry you to the next level. Hallelujah. There is power in the word of God. Please, if you forget everything about this, there is power in the word of God. The last book I will read today is in the book of Psalms. I'm told it's Psalms, isn't it? Psalms. Psalms chapter 1. I'll read from verse 1 to verse 3. Oh, the joy of those who do not follow the advice of the wicked, or stand around with sinners, or join in with scoffers, but they delight in doing everything the Lord wants. Day and night they think about his law. Hallelujah. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers, but
law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the river, river's water, of water, that brings forth its fruit in its season, whose leaves also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. Aye, hallelujah. Number one, we have seen that there is a condition for one to be called blessed, isn't it? You can't just say, I can't just say, oh, my sister, you are blessed. We are misusing this word. Oh, you are blessed. You cannot be blessed if you don't have the blessing. The Bible says, blessed is the man who will be able to walk in the counsel of the wicked. Meaning, this man is righteous. Amen. The person who should be called blessed is a person who walks in righteousness. Am I talking to someone? If you don't walk in righteousness, when we call you blessed, we are misusing the scripture. Isn't it? Praise God. A blessed person is that one who does not walk in the counsel of men, or sit in the seat of sinners, or stand in the path of sinners. Who walks not in the counsel of ungodly, or stand in the path of, not sit in the seat of scornful. Hallelujah. This is the person to be called blessed. You are blessed because you have been able to overcome these snares. But his delight is in the law of the Lord. That's a blessed man. A man who believes upon the word of God. A man who obeys the word of God. He is called blessed. Verse 3 tells me, he shall be like a tree planted. You see, before you become a tree, before you bear fruits, you must first of all not walk in the counsel of the ungodly. Number two, not stand in the path of sinners. Number three, not sit in the seat of scornful. If you don't do these three things, then the Bible calls you blessed. Hallelujah. And you can only overcome this when you meditate upon the word of God. Hey, when you meditate upon the word of God day and night. The Lord says, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates it day and night. Reading the word of God day and night will prevent you from sin. I say it. It will make you not walk in the way of in the counsel of the world, the ungodly. It will avoid you. It will make you avoid the ways of sinners. If you don't know how to overcome sin, read the Bible. Don't go to your pastor and tell him, please lay hands on me. Pastor's hands have no power to give us sin. Hello? Our hands, when they lay hands on you, I can't cure your sin. No. Sin is cured through repentance and going back to where you were before you fell. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the living God. So, when you meditate upon the word of God day and night, then you will be like a tree. Now I can understand why most of us are struggling financially. I now see why we are struggling, me and you. We are struggling financially because we have not been able to avoid to walk in the ways of sinners and godly, to stand in their path, or even to sit in their ways. We have failed to read the word of God day and night. So we have no direction. We don't know where to live. You know, when you believe in the Lord, I was in prayer mountain and a man came and testified that he was really struggling at his home, trying to make ends meet. He was doing so many kinds of businesses. But when he went to the mountain and he slept, after praying for 21 days, the 20th day before he leaves the following day, the Lord appeared to him and told him, do you know what? In your home, there is pure water. You can go and start a company of manufacturing pure water. When he was there that day, someone called him from his village. And this man was living in Nairobi, struggling to live in Nairobi, to make ends meet. But his wealth was where? In his room place. Hallelujah. So when he was preparing to leave the following morning, he received a phone call from the mother. There are people who are looking for you. They say they know that you can help them to come up with a company to manufacture water. He left that moment. Because the Lord was affirming the word that he spoke to him at night. Hallelujah. So some of us, the investment, no matter, some of us are being fired so that we can go and become employers. Where you are doing the wrong thing. When you come out, you will come out of your doesn't do what? Wither. Hallelujah. We are carrying investments. We are employers.
Help us to pray for our brothers. Let us stand as a church and pray for those who
life is unfair and they are going back to sin. Let us be the ambassadors to pray for them. And God will bless us. Let me pray for you. Father, I give you praise and I give you honor. Thank you, Lord, for this word you have given unto us. We celebrate you, my Father, because every word brings awakening in our hearts. Every single blessing, my God, brings speaking to us in this altar. It has challenged us. It has given us something else in us, Lord. The zeal of God is burning inside us, Father. I thank you because of my viewers. Thank you even for those who are in church today. I want to declare a blessing upon them. I release the grace this week to prosper financially. I release favor upon the watch of their heads. I release your power to walk with them, King of Glory. I cover them with the blood of Jesus Christ. I declare that they shall not die. They will live to declare the goodness of the Lord, because the Lord is good and his mercies endure forever. I declare blessing on Monday. I declare blessing on Tuesday. I declare blessing on Wednesday. I declare blessing on Thursday. I declare blessing on Friday. I declare blessing on Sunday. I declare blessing on Sunday. I cover them and I pray that the heavens will be open to receive their prayers. I declare and decree the word of God will dwell in them richly in the name of Jesus. I pray for the fruit of their womb, their children, their sons and their daughters. I declare them blessed, my Father, as their parents go out to work. May you give them grace and protect them from this coronavirus in the name of Jesus. I give you praise for their lives. Thank you for the support that you've been giving us, my Father. Even their financial support I've been sending to this church. I pray for them. You shall bless them and keep them well. May you bless them and lift them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. If you've heard the word and you want to give your life to Christ, just pray this simple prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I have heard your word. I give you my life. I give you my heart. From today, I repent my sins. I choose to follow you because you are our Lord. Blessed be your holy name. Walk with me, Jehovah, and teach me thy ways. I denounce the devil and his ways, and I choose you. Walk with me. May the Holy Ghost come upon me and teach me the ways of God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. May his face shine upon you. Shalom. Until we meet again, may God bless you. Amen.